offensive scheme, system, and philosophy is designed to attack one thing, space. Some teams know how to create it, and others don't, which can drag down even the most talented players and make them mere mortals. Yes, talent is more important than scheme, but if you're not consistently putting that talent in space against the right matchup, your roster will never reach anywhere near its full potential. The Saints offense has consistently torn up the NFL year in, year out for the past 15 seasons. Drew Brees has rewritten nearly every page in the record book, and Sean Payton has proven he's a master at creating space and manipulating matchups. The duo's had quality weapons through their tenure, but then, in 2017, they drafted Alvin Kamara, who is arguably the best dual threat weapon in the league. After winning Offensive Rookie of the Year, he's continued to establish himself as a lethal force, scoring 31 touchdowns in his first two seasons. Now in 2020, he's taken his game to the next level. He leads the NFL in yards from scrimmage and total touchdowns, and through week 4, he has the third most fantasy points ever for a running back. He is a true superstar, but like any superstar, it's important to give the coach credit where credit is due. Sean Payton's running backs have finished first or second in the league in fantasy points every year dating back to 2011. Kamara has special talent and ability in the open field, but how often he's put in the open field in the right matchup is critical to his success. Payton is a master at utilizing formations, film study, and manipulating defensive schemes to put Kamara in the best possible position. He absolutely went off against the Packers. 13 catches, 139 receiving yards were both career highs, and he added 2 touchdowns. With Mike Thomas sidelined the past 3 weeks, you'd think defenses would key even more on Kamara since he's their only proven threat. But Payton has continued to create space, and plenty of it. The Packers have opened the season playing more 4 deep quarters coverages, so Payton constructed the game plan around Kamara attacking the soft underneath coverage. The Saints send out their heavy 3 tight end 13 personnel to force the Packers into their heavier base 4-3 defense, which keeps an extra linebacker on the field. By spreading the formation, which you wouldn't normally with 3 tight ends, this requires the Packers' slower linebackers to cover in space. They're playing what they refer to as Red 7 Poach, but what we'll simply refer to as quarters. It's 4 deep, 3 underneath with the backside in man. Since Payton knows they're going to play quarters, he dials up their shock choice concept. Choice is a corner route from Jared Cook with an option route from Kamara, meaning he can break inside or out depending on the leverage of the defender. Cook's route is designed to obstruct linebacker Chris Barnes, and since Kamara is starting to stem outside, Barnes has to maneuver around Cook, which frees the inside of the field. If he had stayed inside of Cook, anticipating a Texas-type route or something like that, easy enough, Kamara just breaks out. He can win this matchup in his sleep. And since Payton utilized a heavier personnel grouping and spread the formation, Kamara with this matchup and this much open space is simply not fair. From the tight angle, we have a better view of how the concept's design puts tremendous stress and conflict on each defender. Here is Cook on the left with Kevin King in man, and Kamara with Barnes. When Kamara begins to push outside, Barnes has to honor his stem to the flat. And with Cook on a mandatory inside release barreling straight towards him, he has to take one more step to maneuver him in case Kamara really is going outside. But that's the beauty of the option route. When Kamara gets here, if you're him, what are you gonna do? Barnes is already moving outside of Cook. It's an easy read. With Adrian Amos keying the strength of the offense, Kamara just has to break his tackle and scores. It's important for coaching staffs to identify tendencies in the defense, but it's even more important for them to be able to convey and teach what they've found so the players can implement it during the game. You wanna give your team every advantage possible, but overloading them with information will cause them to slow down. When Payton finds something to exploit schematically, he and Kamara know how to take advantage. Check out how the Packers have 3 defenders for just 2 receivers. This gives the Saints and Kamara a pre-snap tip that one of those defenders is blitzing. Which one? Well, when we go back a week prior, the Packers showed a tendency to blitz a safety off the backside of zone runs to create penetration and blow the play up in the backfield. It worked well against the Lions, but when Peyton saw this, he knew he could take advantage. So when the Saints see the extra safety to the twin side, this alerts them something might be coming, as well as subtracts one defender weak. With the two tight ends in the core and Traquan Smith motioning to kick out the forced defender, the Packers are simply outnumbered when Kamara cuts backside. Peyton's game plan prepared the offense to key the extra blitzer pre-snap, so when Kamara saw it before the play, he knew exactly what to do. The Saints are running split zone, which is inside zone with Traquan splitting or sifting across the formation. Kamara will set his path towards the inside leg of the play side guard, then read each gap to the left until he finds an opening. Since he's already keying the extra safety coming down before the play starts, he knows he'll have a favorable matchup backside. He sees the D-tackle stalemated in the A-gap, the Mike charging forwards, the B-gap closed, and the C-gap. If it wasn't for Traquan, Josh Hill would reach Will Redmond and Kevin King would force the run back inside. But because Traquan kicks him out, the Packers are outnumbered. Kamara makes the cut at the perfect time just as Traquan is coming across. He presses outside for a step to help set up Hill's block, then puts Amos on skates. It's important that he doesn't make a big jump cut or a fancy move, but that he wins with speed and acceleration. By saving that fraction of a second, that's the difference between going for 50 yards instead of 35. When good offensive play callers sit down to design a game plan, they begin with understanding the defense's rules first so they can design plays to manipulate them. Kamara is the offensive weapon that you want one-on-one against anybody in the league. But it's important for Peyton to study how a defense is designed so he can identify the holes in their coverage and deploy Kamara to attack them. The Lions notoriously play a ton of man coverage, but Peyton knows it's not as simple as just calling man beaters all day because they play a million different types of man. If you can identify tendencies for which type of man they're calling, you can find mismatches. Here they're playing a version of cover one man called one funnel. It's man on each receiver and specifically designed to stop, believe it or not, Alvin Kamara. These two linebackers will bracket him inside and out. If he goes outside, the other backer would zone off as a rat or vice versa. It should work against the Saints' mesh Y wheel, which is typically a man beater designed to bonk two defenders together chasing the underneath shallow crosses. But in one funnel, Jamie Collins should have leverage on Kamara to the inside, and the other linebacker can help with the other shallow. However, when Kamara slow plays his release, Collins feels Emmanuel Sanders coming, who he would be responsible for if Kamara goes out, so he quickly has to jump around him and chase down Kamara. You could see why one funnel would work against this concept. With both linebackers trained on Kamara and then one coming off to help with the shallow route, it should be solid. If Kamara came out firing and ran the shallow immediately, that'd declare Collins as the man defender and J-Ron Curse the rat. But if Kamara breaks to the left, Collins has to quickly turn and relate to Sanders. He hesitates for a split second, then feels Sanders and has to dodge him. Luckily, Tracy Walker comes off his man, but the more you get Kamara one-on-one with linebackers, eventually it's gonna hit big and the Saints do it a lot. Peyton deserves a ton of credit, but Kamara deserves more. He leads all running backs with 30 receptions and constantly turns small gains into big ones by making defenders miss. He's broken 19 tackles, which is third in the league, and his 9 as a receiver is most in the NFL. Sure, his speed and acceleration are critical, but his ability to shrink his contact surface and contort his body to absorb hits are what make him really special. With the Saints running their two-minute drill right before the half, Breeze sees the Packers are once again playing quarters, so he audibles to a play the Saints have run for years, 82H jerk. It's good against this coverage because it has multiple answers and threatens multiple levels of the defense. The post routes can side adjust to attack the open middle of the field, and it isolates Kamara one-on-one with a linebacker in a lot of space. Breeze knows the Packers want to keep a defender for each receiver and a safety over top on each side to neutralize the post wheel concepts. So he shifts Kamara from the boundary to the field to give him more space to work. Kamara stems outside again on the choice route, and when the backer Ty Summers stays leveraged inside, the read is too easy. He busts through Summers, speeds around the safety, and keeps the Saints driving. Kamara is one of the most demoralizing offensive weapons in the entire NFL. When you pair him with an offensive mind like Sean Payton and a quarterback like Drew Brees, this is when special things happen. Kamara is arguably the biggest threat in the open field, but creating that space in the first place is essential. By using formational advantages, picking up nuances in film, and manipulating defensive rules, the Saints have unleashed Kamara in ways that have maximized his insane potential. His numbers and volume have increased with Mike Thomas sidelined, and they'll dip a bit when he comes back. But without the entire defense fixated on Kamara every single play, his efficiency will only go up. Him, Payton, and Breeze are all perfect fits, complementing and combining each of their strengths together. With the Saints sitting at 2-2, they're going to come out firing. Defenses are just waiting to get shredded, and Alvin Kamara is just getting started.